horse, people. This is a good little video. I mean, I've said this in other videos, and I've had the trolls come and argue, you don't know what you're talking about. How can you tell what a horse sees? Look, it's my belief, after being around horses for a few years, that because horses' eyes are different and they pick up motion and they have a problem with depth perception, and there's all kind of scientific, and if you want to go on my website, I've got a lot of articles on the eyes and where they've done, and they've counted the cones and the rods and the cones and why their night vision is so good, why it looks like daylight to a horse at night. I mean, look, their eyes are different, but for some reason, I've always said white things tend to bother horses more, which I don't understand why they always paint the damn obstacles white. Maybe that's the only way they can get a horse to jump over it. But in all these competitions, you always see things white, 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 very reflective. I think white, because it reflects light so much, horses have a hard time distinguishing what it is. So they tend to be a little bit fearful in reaction. So when they give a reaction to it, people are like, stupid horse, it's just a white bucket, or it's just a white log, or it's just a white line on a road. And I've seen this throughout my life, that horses have this. So I've come to the conclusion through the process of elimination, through learning, through idiots who'll tell you, I'm stereotyping horses. You can't stereotype, that's bad, Rick. You can't judge all horses just because every horse you've ever handled done this. Okay, whatever. That's because you're an idiot. But I digress. Let's stay on point here. I believe horses have problems with white things, and I believe that because it's flashy, it reflects light, and I don't think a horse can tell if it's deep or if it's hollow or if it's blank. So they tend to avoid it, spook around it, or act differently. That's why when the horse reacts something white and I see somebody getting in the horse's ass, stupid horse, it's just this, I'm like, you know what, you're a freaking idiot. Just expect your horse to react differently when something is painted white because it's a normal thing. I don't know why exactly. I have my opinion from watching and observing, but these cattle kind of drive this home. There's nothing in this road but this white line, and these cattle are crossing, and they jump over the white line. But Rick, why? Maybe they were taught. Maybe they know. Maybe there's a bug and there's a spider and they're scared and they're well, that's because you're an idiot. They're jumping over this because they have a problem, because it reflects light and it does something different to their eyes. Remember, prey animals, horses and cattle, herd animals that depend on their numbers and their ability to see predators. Normally their eyes are on the side of the head instead of the front like humans. They are prey animals, therefore their eyes pick up movement and things differently. Now, a predator, a dog, would not jump over this white thing. He would run over it. Because he has his eyes on the front and it's made for focusing and chasing prey and chasing food. So our vision is different. Humans look at a white line and go, it's just a white line. I think prey animals, because of their vision, they do not see a white line. They see a void. Reflective, and these cattle all jump over the white line. But Rick, maybe they were taught. I don't think they were taught, but you can believe that if you want to. It's just the way it is. I've seen it. Somebody sent me this. Go, Rick, you talk about the white line. This video kind of drives it home. And I go, you're right. It's perfect. This video is exactly what I've seen in my years of horses. Is they have problems with white things. Now, the good thing is if you paint something white, horses tend to pay attention to it more. But they also may tend to avoid it or be suspicious of it or not be able to understand that they can walk over it, stand on it, or do things to it. So it's just a give and take. It's not an absolute. I don't have scientific proof. You know, I have the trolls coming here. What's your experience to say this? You don't know what you're talking about. Well, okay, well. Then go be an idiot somewhere else. Okay? I don't know how those people get here. Is it YouTube? Is YouTube like secretly sending my videos and making them play and people have no clue what they're watching and they don't hit play? Suddenly my video just pops up and it starts playing and then they want to start crying in the comments like a freaking crybaby. But all right, I digress. Look, white things, be aware. Horses, prey animals will react funny, differently, strangely, suspiciously, of things white. Why it happens, we may not know, but it does happen. It's pretty consistent. And if you work around or with horses, it would probably make you a little bit better understanding of your horse instead of blaming the horse for being stupid or ignorant or spooking over something that's not there, and my horse is dumb, and it's the breeding, and it's the color, and it's the last trainer's fault, and there's all these excuses on why your horse does this, when in fact, it's pretty freaking normal. You just don't have the ability to understand that and to process it, so you want to blame the horse. All right, well, in that there, I thought this was a pretty good little video. Little cattle jumping over white things. Even a little baby that ain't been around that long knows to jump over it. Rick, who taught it that? It learned it in a womb. It's been jumping over white things since before it was born. All right, we'll end that there. Buddy, Miss T, you're good boys.